Good morning, all of you. Now, we will start economics chapter number 2, that is people as a resource. In the chapter number 1, story of village Palam, we have discussed about factors of production. So what are factors of production? Raise your hands. Yes, Vanshika.
Ma'am, land, labor, physical capital, and ma'am, human capital.
Yes. In the first chapter, we have already discussed about land, labor, and physical capital. And it was written in that chapter also that human capital. And another name of human capital is also called entrepreneur. That is our chapter number 2. So, when we are talking about people as a resource, human beings that are also a natural resource, but make other natural resources more useful. So when we are talking about human capital, so that means process of human resources into HCF. And what is the full form of HCF in economics?
Ma'am, human
human
resource, ma'am.
Yes, Samya Gupta.
Ma'am, human
capital.
Human capital formation.
One by one. I told you to raise your hands only. So human capital formation and process of human resources to human capital formation, health, education, and skills. These are three elements which require. But before starting this, what we will study in this chapter, that is the efforts to explain population as an asset. Can anyone tell me the meaning of asset?
Ma'am, any property?
Yes, asset means property. So this is the process to make human population into an asset rather than a liability. Now you are liability for your parents. That means responsibility. And they are looking after each and every. When you will convert into human resources to human capital, that means after completing your education, your skills, that means training or health years, then you are able to earn and you will convert into an asset. So that means people as a resource is a way that refers to countries working people, employed people. That is in terms of their production, skills and abilities. And next is population becomes human capital. When there is investment made in the form of education, training and medical care. So that means human capital is the stock of skill and productive knowledge. And that's why it is also called that is entrepreneur. In chapter number 1, we have little bit discussed about physical capital. Can anyone tell me the meaning of physical capital? Raise your hands only. Physical capital. Yes, Vanshika.
Ma'am, physical capital like ma'am money and ma'am tools.
Yes, physical capital means that is money. That is again having two parts. Kaun kaun se part hai? That is?
Ma'am, working capital.
Working capital.
Working capital and working capital. But still, we can easily understand, or we can easily understand the difference between physical and human capital. How they are different? Land and other resources, like fixed capital, jo humne baat kari thi, and human resources can be nurtured through education and health. Human resources can bring a change in other resources, because human beings are able to utilize land and other natural resources. But other natural resources cannot change or affect human resources. So this is the difference, and this is the reason that human beings are an important natural resource, which makes other natural resources more useful. So when we are talking about population, working population of the country, so normally in India, we make population responsible for all the negative, low economic growth. But that is not only the negative aspect, there is a positive side of a large population, which is often overlooked, because we always considered about the negative side. Problems. How can we provide food, education, health? And during the corona period especially. So when existing human resources developed by becoming more educated and healthy, it can convert into human capital, which makes to the productive power of the country and called physical capital formation. And investment point of view, investment, what is the aim of investment? Why do people invest? Kyun karte hain aap investment? Yes, Bhavya? Yes, Bhavya.
Can I tell?
Yes. What is the reason?
For economic prosperity.
For a profit, in a simple word, we can say investment, the hope of profit, to earn profit. And this is economic the reason prosperity. Your parents are investing so much money in your education. So investment in human capital, whether it is through education, training, and medical care, it yields a return just like investment in physical capital. And how profit will be there? In the form of higher incomes earned because of higher productivity of the more educated or the better trained person, as well as the higher productivity of healthier people. Okay, so this is the beginning of the